Okay, we are going to talk about how the function calls jump from one function to another function and how do they return back. For instance, here, let's take this example here. I have a function add integer x and y. It computes the addition of x and y. And it prints x and y. And here it's a product, not the sum. It's same parameters, integer x and y, and it computes the product and it prints. And here I, in the main function, I call the product. Very simple, right? But how does it know to jump to the product? Execute these statements, and when it's done, it should come back to the next statement in here. How does it know? And how does it know that these are local variables x, y? Okay, to get to that, let's talk about the activation records. Activation records are the vital important data structure functions use to execute, okay, and manage local variables, incoming variables, the parameters we talked about, right, the copy by value and all that, and the return address upon exit. When the function is done, where do the instruction go to continue? Right? So it has to know where it should go after it's done. Right? In this example again, add, product, and a main function. We have three functions. And each of them are independent of each other. Okay? And here, if you look at the main function, like I said, it requests three main variables, three main information to execute. Now, for the main function, what is called activation record is nothing but it's a local variable. What does the local variable have? A equal to 10, B equal to 20. We have that. Incoming variables. Does the main function have any incoming variables? No, it's empty for now. We didn't pass any incoming variables to it. Return address upon exit. When the main function is done completing, what do we get? Where do we go? We go to the operating system, right? Operating system takes control of it. So this is a simple example for the main function. Let's look at the product function. Activation record for the product. Again, three information. What is the local variable? We have only one, the result, in here. What are the incoming variables? X and Y. X and Y. And what is the return address upon exit? In this case, line 22, in this example, for instance. We call the product A, B. And when the instruction goes in here at line number 11, it executes each and every line. And upon exit, upon line number 16, it has to come to 22, right? So that's what we have. For this program, upon when the product returns from execution, it'll go to 22. So this is manage runtime. Remember, runtime, this is not a static, it's a dynamic. At runtime, it manages this information. Okay? Remember that. So that is for the product. And then, every time it executes these instructions, right, these instructions, there's something called a program counter. It, for instance, it keeps incrementing as each and every statement is executed. That's called a program counter. So together with, along with the activation record, the system manages a program counter that stores the line number where currently it's executing. It keeps incrementing if there are no jumps in executions. Okay. For instance, let's take example. So we talked about two things right now. Just to be clear, we talked about activation record, which for each function call, remember that. It's not one for each function, for each function call. And then we have a program counter. Program, you will read these two concepts, program, in the operating systems course. When you go into third year or fourth year, you'll read about operating systems or compilers. They teach you about these two things, but I'm explaining to you so you know how these are executed. Okay. Go back to our PowerPoint. So let's take the simple example in here. At runtime, program counter is 20, means it's executing a line number 20. Okay. Now I'm done at executing that. So my activation record is A equal to 20, B equal to 20. Local variables is A and B. The incoming variable, again, like we talked, we're not passing anything to the main functions, empty. And the return address is operating system. Okay. Our program counter is 20. We are now at line number 20. Now line number 21 at runtime, program counter is 21. It's executing line number 21, which is what? The function call, right? So this function call gets another activation record here. You see that this is for the main. And as soon as the instruction jumps to 11, which is the program counter, we have a new activation record. Okay. So what are the three information we have? Local variable, which is what? Result. What is incoming variable? X comma Y. Incoming variable X comma Y. And upon exit, return address upon exit is 22. That means when you are done executing this program, go back to 22. That's what it says. Okay. So this is how the compilers manage, the system manages these things at runtime. Same thing at the line number 14. I'm executing, the program counter is 14. Executing that. Upon exit, where do I go now? Now it's done at here, it's done. Now it has to answer this question, who called me? I should transfer execution to the caller. I check my activation record for return address. So it goes back to 22, right? The execution goes to 22, but this is what the magic happens. When it's done at product, executing the product, this gets removed. See that? Now I'm done executing the product. I'm here at 22. The activation record for the function call product is erased, is removed from memory. Now my program count is 22. I'm done. Oops. Some point, usually we do not use line. Yeah, this is just a simple example I've given you using line numbers. In reality, it's not real line numbers. It's instructions that the compiler generates. Then it deals with those instruction sets. Okay? Line numbers, I'm only giving you as an example. Okay? Then we need to understand the, I'm sorry, we don't have to really bother about size of activation records at this moment, but you have to understand that it changes for each function call. Okay. Now let's take a different example here. Add product. Now I change my program. I called add after the product, right? So we have activation record for the main function, same as above. My program, I'm done with product, which we did before. Now I'm line number 22, right? I'm done 20, I'm done the 21. In this program, now at 22. My activation record for add function is, local variable is result, we have that. Incoming variable x comma y, see that? And the return address is, should be 23. Okay, now I'm executing this function, add, because you call me at 22. My program counter is 7. I'm done here. It stores the value of the computations in here. Result is how much? 10 plus 20, 30, right? It stores that. Whatever computations done, it's getting stored in the local variable. I'm done executing this add function. I'm at line number 9. Look at that here. What is my return address? 23. So when I'm done here, I'll go and see my activation record where I should jump. It'll go and jump to 23. And when I come back to 23, my activation record for the add function is erased. Is gone. I am left with my activation record at for the main function. So when your program finishes, activation record and program counter are all freed and empty with no trace of your program. Yes. When you are done with your program, what do? You get the prompt, right? You get the prompt. So that's what it is. So we looked at this, how the scope of the variable, right? How we deal with different variables. You see that even though the product has a local variable result, and here we have another variable result, they are completely different because of our activation records. This is for the add result, and this is for the product. Okay, there are two completely different local variables with a different memory locations, completely different, isolated. That is how system manages your local variables from different functions. Okay, it's a very important concept, very neat concept, I should say. And without this activation records, you can never ever implement functions. It's so important and it's so neat to understand all this. Okay, so take this PowerPoint, go over the this video and see how it's done, and we'll. So the basic line I just want to finish here is, every function has at least 3 minimum information it stores, which is the activation local variables, the incoming variables, and the return address. Okay?